trying. We've been trying before.
Yes, I agree with you.
Do you trust that this new? We do have a new governor.
Right.
So it will make a difference.
I hope so. At this. Listen, keep my fingers crossed. Let's see. Let's give him a chance. We'll see. And if it doesn't work, we have democracy, and then we send him home. Okay. We get another government, right? Okay. That's the way it goes. That's democracy. Right.
The business world here in Curaçao, they are represented by several entities, including FEBESE, Cámara de Comercio, registered, everybody pays belasting, etc. And the Minister of Finance started with Obey to put more, let me put it very simply, put more attention on it so that the government can collect it to bring it in.
Yes.
It can be more effective if the government has it, or if it's lost, 30% of people don't comply.
They don't pay their taxes, that's what you're saying, right?
Well, yes, 30% don't pay the taxes, 30% don't come across with their Obey, 70% does. Now, 70% of the people in the business are paying with their taxes are paying for the 100%
of course.
Of the people.
That's not fair.
Of course not.
Listen, if we want a government to function, we have to pay our taxes, period.
Okay, but how we bring them to understand that?
Well, it's education, it's personal integrity, and simply control. You cannot have power over people if you don't control it. Check it, and make sure there's no corruption. Mm-hmm. Do it. I mean, absolutely, I think there was some idea to have cash registers or something like that. There are all kinds of technical systems.
Well, a chip
systems.
In the cash register.
Yes, but it's very easy to do, and there's all kinds of systems. And again, we are not the only person in the world with that problem. You know, that is a worldwide problem, and it's easy to solve. There are hundreds of solutions for it.
Is 70% or 30% on the high side? Or
We have seen a lot of countries. A typical example was Hong Kong. In Hong Kong, nobody paid their taxes, right? And then the Chinese came in, the British left, the Chinese came in and said, no way, we simply put you in jail for the rest of your life, and now everybody pays their taxes.
Oh, okay.
Big change, believe me.
Should we do that here too?
That's not up to me. That's up to the politicians, that's up to a government, that's up to the manager of the country. They have to make it work.
Okay, but are you for a harder stance of the government?
I think it's totally unfair that some people get away with not paying and let other people pay for your children, your benefits, and so it's not fair. You have to do something. You have to be a lot more stricter.
Okay, I want to get into things that are happening on the planet that affect us, and especially the oil that is... The price is going sky high, and we have a country here, the third or fifth country in the world with the amount with regards to amounts of oil. Can't we negotiate a better price?
Well, that's up to Mr. Chavez. I seriously doubt that he wants to do that. At the same time, you're looking a little bit too much at media and publicity. The price of oil in real value without inflation has not gone up very much. And what you see today in the market after the unrest in the Middle East are forward contracts. So delivery is often 48 months from now, or even more than that, 16 months or 72 months. So years from now, it's a projection of the forward market. And in the forward market is a lot of speculation. Speculators bid on the price, and they bid the price up. Does that also cause today's inventory to go up in value? Yes, a little bit, but not that much, you know.
Okay.
So that's number one. Number two, we've also seen it when the price goes up, suddenly people use less. Remember the last hike? Nobody was driving that far anymore, and you were suddenly very, very, very
stingy,
economic and stingy
with their expenses.
And that is a big spin-off. The hybrid cars, electric cars, you know, we invented them, they're available on the market, and then oil went really cheap, and we didn't do it anymore. And now we have an incentive to do that again. So from that point of view, I'm very happy, because with expensive oil, we will make the change to a different vehicle. Okay. Finally, it's about time.
Okay, but is this the real start? Because we've seen
couple before.
Other, yes,
right.
And it didn't pick up. Is this the real beginning of the change?
I was watching Obama today. Now, please realize, in the United States, electric cars and hybrid cars still have an extra tax. That they're super taxed,
yes,
in order to protect the old-fashioned cars. And here's Obama finally saying, it's about time, you stop that nonsense. We have to turn it around the other way.
Of course, yes.
So, if anything, this
development... To give more impulse,
yes,
and
course,
initiative, we incentive.
This helps us in our development. This helps us to get away from all those gas-guzzling cars.
Of course, we don't see it reflected in cars here.
Not yet. And why? I mean, we have an island, we would have a perfect island with electric cars. It would be so easy to do.
Okay, but especially with the prices. 40 miles that way, they buy gas for...
It's totally ridiculous and totally not necessary.
Yes.
And why be dependent on one dictator or another?
Okay. A little farther in the,
yes,
Middle East,
yes,
how is that wave, if I can call it that? Tunisia, Egypt,
yes,
and now Muammar Gaddafi's country, Libya.
No, Libya, of course, Yemen, also in Jordan today, very extensively. Well, first of all, I think it's extremely exciting, and what is happening is it's world history, a history in the making, and it's extremely exciting. I'm extremely happy to see what is happening.
Mm-hmm.
We have been talking for years about fundamentalist Islam, right?
Yes.
The terrorists were going to take over the world. These are not terrorists. These are people from the street. They don't
of
want
course.
To have anything to do with terrorists, you know?
Of course, yeah.
So suddenly we see Muslims turn out to be normal people. And they want to have, just like here in Curaçao, welfare and well-being. They want to make more money, and they want their families and their kids to have a good life.
Yes.
And we see all these horrible dictators who've been ripping them off for billions and billions and billions. And that is now no longer tolerated. They simply say, no more. This is the end of it.
Well, after Tunisia, there were commentators, especially from,
yes,
the States, that were saying, this is not going to be contagious to the other countries.
Oh, it is, absolutely.
But it
right.
Is it? It is appearing to be.
I've been writing about it for years, and it was very funny. I published an article on Follow the Money, I think it was in January 18, and I listed the countries as they succeeded in the domino effect as we
and
see it today.
And it is in the same...
It's exactly the same order. So, no, it was very apparent.
Okay.
I've traveled a lot in those countries, and I still do. I still go there a lot. It was brewing. It was absolutely going. I'm now on my way to Sudan. And also in Sudan, I'm extremely happy with what happened. The segregation of the North and the South finally came through after a bloody civil war for 20 years.
Yes.
I mean, the number of people who got killed, 2.5 million people got killed, and it's over, you see?
Sure. But there was no hype about that as it is now with these North African countries.
But